I've been joined today by Trinidad and Tobago midfielder Jomal Williams, an El Salvador-based professional who is currently in El Salvador, having just agreed to a new contract with El Salvador Premier League team AD Metapan. Jomal has been in El Salvador since last year, June, consistently in the country of El Salvador. He has not traveled since. He moved into the El Salvador Professional League circuit earlier in 2019, around February, around that time. And today he will give us an update as to what his position is right now. If we can recall, we will remember that Jomal was one of those players, those Trinidad and Tobago footballers, who was stranded in El Salvador around March, April, when the pandemic really took off. It forced him into a difficult situation, which caused him to reach out to the authorities here in Trinidad and Tobago, most of the Trinidad and Tobago Football Association, who has assisted in the efforts to make sure that he is comfortable. However, today Jomal will give us an update as to what the last few weeks has been for him across in El Salvador. Jomal, thanks for joining us today.
Yeah, no problem. It's a pleasure to be here, Sean.
Jomal, I know it's been difficult, difficult times for you, but you have survived. I can see that you have survived. You know, your upbringing in Trinidad and Tobago, from the community that you came from, would have possibly prepared you for this. Tell us what the process has, what the journey has been so far.
So far, it's a first time thing for me, but I've been taking it day by day. It's been a bit difficult at times, but so far it's been okay. You know, I've come this far, so I don't have much of a complaint at this moment.
Let's go back to around maybe March, April, when the pandemic started to take its course. The borders were closed in Trinidad and Tobago. You were not allowed to return home, and you ran out of a contract as well, which kind of put you in a difficult position. Tell us what it was like being able to having to deal with that.
For me, it was very difficult. It was very, very difficult at the moment. Exactly, without being without a contract, you know, just here, going weeks without knowing if I'm going to resign with my team or what, you know, it's been very difficult, you know, not being able to leave the country, you know, here all alone most of the times. And it's just been very hard for me, and I've just been taking it day by day, you know, and hoping that something comes out of it positive.
Some measures were put in place to try to give you some level of comfort. How did that work out?
Well, it's been good. It's been good. It's been good because, okay, TTFA and Unicoma have been trying their best to make me as comfortable as possible. They have been providing food stuff, you know, because as you know, that I'm out of a contract, so I'm not really receiving a salary at this moment. So they have been trying their best to support me in every way that they can.
Tell me about some good news that you would have received in recent times where the club has offered you a new contract, but there is still something that has to be settled in order for you to pursue this and to be able to engage as a professional footballer with the team. Tell us about that.
Well, for me, re-signing my contract for another year has been something positive, has been something that helped me to relax a bit more here during this pandemic. And it's just that one thing has been bothering me a little bit, And so far, that I believe that the TTFA has been helping me out is with the renewal of my passport. You know, it has been expired June the 2nd. And, you know, in order for me to register for the new season, I need to renew my passport. But so far, TTFA has been trying their best to help me out with when it comes to that. I've also been in touch with the commissioner, Guy Griffith, and he's also trying his best to see how he can help me.
All right. Jomal, you know, being in El Salvador, a country in Central America, they have their challenges, just like Trinidad and Tobago, in dealing with this pandemic. What has it been like across there in terms of what have you seen? What are you allowed to do? Has the team been able to be in training, any sort of physical activity?
Well, honestly, I haven't been able to do much. You know, as you can see, you cannot leave the home. Here, it's a bit different. They take things a little more serious, you know, And me leaving my home, it was never an option for me because I've also tried to take care of myself because I know in this situation, it's very serious. I've seen people die. I've seen people fall sick, very sick. And for me, I've just been home. I try to exercise as much as I can home. And that's about it.
Tell us about some of the things that you're allowed to do or generally in El Salvador, people are allowed to do, and some of the things that they definitely cannot engage in.
Well, here in El Salvador, some of the things that you can do, there is something called a DUI. It's like a card. You have a number on it, and they give you this. If you are, for example, if you are number 2 on the card, you can leave to go to the supermarket on Tuesday. If you are number 3, you go on Wednesday. And here, I know something you cannot do. You cannot walk without your mask, without your hand sanitizer. You need to buy one little bottle of hand sanitizer. When the police stop you, these are the things you have to be able to show. If you cannot, they take you very serious. They cry you into quarantine, maybe for 15 days. So yeah, there are some things and some things you can.
Have you been tested for COVID since you've been there?
Yeah, I've been tested once. I've been tested once for COVID, and so far I've been okay.
What is the situation with the club now? How are they going to prepare for the season that is going to start in a few weeks' time?
Well, to be honest, it looks like everything is coming along good. You know, we began training on Monday. On Monday, please God. And so far, everything is okay. You know, we've been talking in the group. Everyone has been doing what they have to do to prevent being positive with this coronavirus. So far, everything is okay.
Well, you know, you've grown up in Piccadilly Street, Port of Spain. You know, and you've graduated from there. You would have gone to W Connection, where a lot of your development took place before you made it into the national setup at the youth team level, under 17 team, into under 20, and then your senior team debut as well. Tell us a bit about, you know, how that has prepared you for life today, as a professional footballer, that upbringing in Port of Spain and environs, into W Connection and to present day.
Well, coming from where I grew up, Sean, it's different. You know, everything is different. It changes your mentality. You know, there's a lot of bad things, but there's also things that you can take positive out of the community that I grew up from. You understand? And I have been able to take the positive out of the negative, which has been happening around me and my community, to try to become something in my football career. You know, W Connection have given me an opportunity to become a professional. They have helped me along the way a lot. They have tried to teach me what it takes to be a professional, and I have taken as much as I can. So I just want to say thanks to them for all they have done for me. And as we were saying, Sean, it's been very difficult, which part I've been growing up from. And I just take it day by day, and I take the positives out of it. And now here I am.
Obviously, you've been able to reflect on your journey so far, and that has, in a sense, given you a platform to want to do better, to want to inspire others. You have some teammates, some former teammates, some current players who would have been looking up to you, who are facing a situation back in Trinidad and Tobago where they're not sure what the footballing future of the country is going to be like. Nobody knows when the Pro League is going to start again. Nobody knows when we're actually going to be active. And they're all hoping for that opportunity. What message would you have for them in terms of, you know, keeping faith and being patient and continuing to have dreams and ambitions?
Well, my message to them is that, as you say, just keep the faith, keep working every day, keep praying, asking God to make this situation that the whole world is in pass eventually. And it's simple. Just keep dreaming, believing, knowing what you want in life, knowing what you want to become in life, and just keep working every day towards it. That's it.
When you look at the situation with Trinidad and Tobago's football, the World Cup draw has come out. Obviously, we've not played an international friendly for 2020, dating back to 2019 when we played the Nations League qualifier against Honduras. There's been no active football for the national team. You must have a yearning desire to wear the national shirt again. You've seen what our World Cup group looks like. Hopefully it will commence in October as scheduled. What are your thoughts on that whole thing?
Well, first and foremost, when I saw the format, I was very motivated. You know, I every day I will think of this. Every day I think about working hard to make the national team. Right now, that's my main goal, to make the national team again, to be able to wear the T-shirt, represent my country. You know, but so far, right now in the whole setup of the TTFA, there has been some ups and downs. So every day I pray, hopefully, that something positive come out of it, that we will be able to regroup as a national team and as a country and be able to represent the country once again.
Obviously, you would have been in touch with some of your teammates who are based outside as well, the captain, Kaleem Highland, Aubrey David, is close by in Costa Rica as well. What has been the communication like in terms of, you know, the boys looking forward to representing the red, white, and black again?
Well, these guys have the same ambition as me. You know, all we want to do is just be able to represent the country once again, you know, and hoping, all of us just hoping that the TTFA at this moment make the right decision in terms of getting back the country as it was, being able to play football again. And it's about the same thing. We have the same ambition, just to represent the country once again. At this moment, I'm just keeping my fingers crossed that I will be allowed to renew my new passport, and because that will keep me playing professionally here in El Salvador. And to Trinidad and Tobago, I just want to make an appeal to you guys that to keep safe, keep following all the measures, and I look forward to seeing you once again.
Okay. All right, Jomal, thanks a lot for this, and we want to wish you the best, and we'll continue to monitor your progress.
All right, thanks, Jomal.